Most High told us to come out in the highways and the byways and speak to the ears of our people. We're here to speak to the ears of you because many of you are deaf. We're here to give you the vision. Many of you have eyes but can't see. So we're hoping that the word of the Lord will touch at least one of you.
Shalom, shalom.
Because as the Bible tells us in 2 Andrews chapter 15, verse 1, speak to the people. Go ahead, King.
The words of prophecy.
For we are out here to speak to you. The words of prophecy. According to the Bible. We are living in the last days. And so we're here to speak to you. The words of prophecy. What are the words of prophecy? The words of prophecy are the words of the Bible. From the book of Genesis all the way to the book of Revelation. The book that many of you have in your homes collecting dust.
Yes, man.
The book that many of you don't open up and read. The book that many of you have forsaken. And so therefore, you don't know your power. You don't know your God. So you walk around in darkness. You walk around worshiping wicked holidays, praising and modesty a wicked God and not the true God of the Bible. So like the scripture says, we are here for our people. We're here to give them this prophecy, God.
Which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord.
For we're here to give you the prophecies. That's the book of the Lord. That the men of the Lord will have in our mouths. And through this speaker, we hope that the people will hear the true word of the Lord. For there are many false prophets in the day. There are many people who claim they know Christ and they don't know the Son of God. They teach a false doctrine. They teach wickedness. They don't teach the true law of Moses, which are the commandments of Moses to our people. They don't teach the true way of the Son of the Most High, Yahweh Shai in the Hebrew. They teach the way of the wicked. They teach that every man in the kingdom is going to make it in heaven, no matter how wicked and how sinful they are. They teach that anybody can make it in heaven. They teach that the Most High God loves everybody. But according to the Bible, the Most High God does not love everybody. The Most High God, he has a hatred to many of you wicked people. Many of you people who don't follow his ways, who don't adhere to his commandments and his laws and statutes. The Most High God is against fornicators. The Most High God is against adulterers. The Most High God is against homosexuals. The Most High God is against transvestites. The Most High God is against lesbians. The Most High God is against murderers, killers, rapists. The Most High God is against all of that. But many of you, you don't have knowledge of the Most High God. And you're walking and living in sin. And what is sin? Sin is the transgression of the law. That is what sin is. What is the law? The law of Moses. So if you're living your life, and you're an Israelite, and you are going against the laws of Moses, if you're going against the covenant that the Most High God made with Israel, then you are a sinner. If you don't observe the Sabbath, which is coming when the sun goes down, you are a sinner. If you worship wicked holidays, like Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year's, birthdays, Valentine's Day, Easter, then you are a sinner. For the Most High will say on Judgment Day, depart from me, for I never knew you, ye that worketh iniquity. And that's what a lot of you are doing. A lot of you are workers of iniquity. A lot of you don't give honor, glory, and praise to the Most High God because you don't know the law. You don't adhere to the law. You refuse to hearken to the words of the Lord because you want to lean on your own understanding according to the Bible. That's right. Many of you, you think you know God. You have a form of godliness, but you don't have the knowledge thereof. And so you're going to be destroyed. And so the Hebrew Israelites will come out here to tell you the good news for those who want to repent. But we also are here to tell you the judgment that's coming to those who refuse to hearken to the words of the Lord. Read that from the top again, Ken.
This is 2 Ezra chapter 15, verse 1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the word of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord.
So we're speaking the words of prophecy. We're speaking the words that are going to get you saved. We're speaking the words that will protect you on the return of Hamas that Yahweh shot. But the question is, are you open to listening? Are you open to receiving the Spirit of the Lord?
It is foolish.
Or are you content to continue to walk in darkness? Continue to walk in your wickedness. For we come out here in the highways and the byways, not for filthy lucre's sake. We're not out here passing the plate around. We're coming out here in the highways and the byways because we love our people. We want our people to get salvation. We want our people to understand that they are the chosen of God, the apple of his eye. But many of you have rejected the favor that the Most High has given you. And for that, you're either going to have to repent or you're going to die with the nuclear fire. Give me 1 Corinthians 2 and 12. 1 Corinthians 2 and 12. For we just out here to give you the word of the Lord. Anybody want to learn the words of the Lord, the true words of the Lord, then we're here to answer your question. We're here to take all the doubt out of your minds about the scriptures. For you are listening to the scholars of the Lord, the true men of the Lord. And so this is the time now, for we're in a grace period. This is the time now for you to awaken out of your sleep, for you to come back to the Lord, for you to teach your children what true salvation is, for you to teach your brothers and your sisters. For we are here, for the Israelites, God's chosen people. Read that, King.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world.
For we haven't received the spirit of the world. For we dropped the spirit of the world. And we're out here to teach you that you have to give up the spirit of the world. What is the spirit of the world? What is the spirit of the world? The spirit of the world is the wickedness in the wicked holidays. Sodomy, transvestitism, transgenderism, homosexuality.
Shut the fuck up!
Your mother is a whore. That is the wickedness of the world. And we're out here to tell you to come out of the wickedness. But we're not talking to the wicked white woman who thinks that she runs the world. We're not here talking to the wicked white man. For you're the devil, the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
We're out here to talk to God's chosen people.
Right.
The so-called blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, a Negro and Indian.
That's right.
They walk by. They walk by and scoff us. They walk by and cuss us out. Because they don't have God in them. They don't have the people. They don't have right. All they have is wickedness in them. for they are of the world. But we are here to get you to come out of the world, you Israelites. We are here to tell you that there is no success in the world as far as the Most High is concerned. But you got to come out of the world and be separate. Read on, King. Matter of fact, start from the top.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world.
We have dropped the spirit of the world. For once we were in this world, doing a lot of the wicked things you've done, but the Most High God has called. And so at this point, we are not of this wicked world. For we are of the spiritual things that relate to the Most High, not the carnal things that relate to the world.
But the spirit which is of God. But the spirit which of God.
For we're here to teach you. We're here to teach you the spirit, the true spirit of the Most High God. We're here to give you an opportunity to get saved, to give you an opportunity to repent of your wicked ways. While you have an opportunity to do so, while you are living in this time of grace, you know?
But the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God.
For we're here to teach you those things that are given to us, the blessings that are given to us by the Most High. For there is a God. His name is
Yahweh.
His son. His name is Yahweh Shai. And we're here to teach and preach to you the gifts of the Most High God. The so-called Blacks, Hispanic, and Native Americans. You are God's chosen people. And you deserve the gifts of the Most High God. But many of you will forsake the gifts of the Most High God. Because you refuse Him. And in the book of Isaiah, that you reject the Most High, then you have rejection coming your way. We know.
13. Which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth.
For we are here speaking the words of the Lord. We are here speaking the words of God, from the book of Genesis to the book of Revelation. We're not out here speaking man's words. We're not out here speaking man's wisdom. But man's wisdom is folly. Man's wisdom is corruption. Man's wisdom leads to wickedness. And so we are here to speak the words and the wisdom of the Lord, telling our people to awake out of sleep.
Look at this, man.
To walk the narrow path, not the broad way, the way that leads to destruction.
Right.
We are, okay?
But which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual.
For we are here to bring you the good news of the gospel. We are here to give you those things that are spiritual, not those things that are of man's wisdom, not those things that are carnal. We are here to tell you the truth of the Bible, to get your salvation right, to get you off that pork chop, to get you off that crab leg,
right,
to get you off them shrimps,
right,
and that lobster, and that squid, and that calamari, to get you off all of those abominations. We are here to give you the word and the wisdom and the truth of the Lord. Not the wisdom of man, not the wisdom that leads to darkness, but the wisdom that leads to righteousness, the wisdom that leads to salvation.
14. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God.
For all of you, and many of you, you are the natural man, leading on man's wisdom, for you are not the spiritual man. But when the Bible speaks of the natural man, he speaks of those who live in darkness, those who live in wickedness. That's the natural man. Those who don't love themselves, so they go get hair weaves. Those who can't grow their own hair because they're eating too much pork. They're eating too much shrimp. They're cutting their hair, Red, blue, green, red, blonde. But they don't have knowledge of themselves. But we're here to give them the knowledge of the Lord. You gotta get me.
But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him.
For the natural man, the people who are natural, the ones who worship holidays that are not in the Bible, teach their sons and daughters that there's a Santa Claus. Teach their sons and daughters that there's a rabbit that lays eggs. For those are the ways of men. Those are the ways of the natural man.
For they are foolishness unto man, neither can he know them because they are spiritually discerned.
For you don't know those things of the Most High God because you are too carnal. But we're here to teach you the things of the Most High God. We're here to teach you the things that matter because we're living in the last days where there's judgment coming upon earth. We're here to teach you those things that are righteous, not those things that are carnal. We're here to teach you those things that are spiritual, those things that are going to get you salvation and going to get your sons and daughters salvation. But many of you reject knowledge. You reject the knowledge of the Most High God. When it is time for us to awaken out of sleep, can't y'all see y'all wearing masks? Can't y'all see that there's blood rivers? Can't y'all see there's locusts? Can't y'all see that there's earthquake in diverse places? Can't y'all see there are wars and rumors of wars? Can't you see all of these signs that we're living in a time where the Savior is coming back in the second coming and that you need to prepare yourselves? For you are living carnal lives, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You are God's chosen people. Tú eres israelitas. Tú eres la gente de Dios. But you don't know that you're God's chosen people because you don't open the book and read. You don't read the Bible. You let the false prophets tell you what's in the Bible. But you don't open up the Bible and read it. How many of you got a Bible at home and don't open it up and read it? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. You don't raise your hand because you know you're ashamed. But the Bible says that those who trust in the Lord, they'll never be ashamed. They'll never be ashamed to know that they're going to have salvation, that they are called by the Most High God. But many of our people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because the churches have lied to our people. The churches have taught that it's okay to be a homosexual. The churches have taught it's okay to be a lesbian, a tranny. It's okay to hate your brother as long as you just ask for forgiveness. But the problem is, you ask for forgiveness and then you go out and you do the same wicked things again and again and again. So there is no repentance. But we're here to teach you repentance. You so-called black, Latinos, Hispanics, Native Americans, and Negro to Indian descent. We're here to teach you that it's time to get right with the Lord. It's time to get that camera out your head and get your common sense back. It's time for you to trust in the Lord and be your natural selves. Come back to your natural language. Come back to your true nationality. That's what we're here to tell you. For it's as simple as that. Continue on, King. I think he's on verse 14. 15? Okay. Go ahead, King.
But he that is spiritual judges all things.
But he that is spiritual. For the Most High God said that we can judge if we trust in him. If we live a spiritual life. If we practice the righteous acts. We're not hypocrites. We're out here telling you the truth. But we can judge spiritually. Because the Most High has given us the Spirit. of righteousness. He's given us the spirit of discernment. And so if our people are going off, if our people are not doing what is expedient to the Most High, we, in righteousness, we can rebuke them. The Bible tells us that righteous rebuke is better than secret love. And we love our people. And so rebuking you, making a judgment, that's righteousness with the Most High. As long as we are doing those things that are righteous with the Most High. Go ahead, King.
But he that is spiritual judges all things, yet he himself is judge of no man.
That's right. If you're spiritual, no man who is wicked can judge that which is spiritual. God's chosen people, people who love the Lord, people who follow his commandments, people who observe his holy days, his Sabbath, people who abstain from abominations, so they can't be judged by the wicked. But in righteousness, we carry the badge of honor, the badge of glory, because the Most High God has given us that badge, because we have earned it through loving him and trusting in him and submitting to his law, statutes, and commandments, and doing those things that he has asked us to do, even in our captivity. So what verse you on, King? Bring out 16, it's gonna be the last.
For who hath known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him, but we have the mind of Christ.
Well, the scripture says, how many of you have known the mind of the Lord? How many of you can say you really know the mind of the Lord? And many of you can't say you know the mind of the Lord, because you're living in darkness. And the Most High doesn't live in darkness. The Most High lives in the light. The Most High lives in the truth. So only the men of the Lord can know the mind of the Lord on this level, on the level of the truth, on the level of his good news and his gospel. And so we're here to tell you to come into the Lord, learn the Lord, learn his ways, so you too can understand the mind of the Lord coming out of his scriptures from the book of Genesis all the way to the book of Revelation. For it is expedient that you know the mind of the Lord, because then you'll be guided in all your ways. Then you know that your goings and comings are protected by the angels of the Lord. Instead of walking up and down, not knowing if tomorrow you'll be here, not knowing if your judgment will be coming upon you because you have forsaken the Most High God. So, we say to you in these highways and byways, come, listen to the word of the Lord, so that you will have the mind, the knowledge and the wisdom of the Most High while you have an opportunity, because your time is running out. We are at the 11th hour. It is time for you to awake out of your sleep. What you bring that out, King?
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 55 and verse 6. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found.
For the Bible tells you to seek the Lord while he may be found. Stop walking up and down these streets not realizing that you got a duty to the Most High God to seek him, and not to just live in folly, not to just be carnal, worried about what club you're going to, what drugs you're going to take, how much harm you're about to commit. But seek you the Lord while you have an opportunity. That
call ye upon him.
Call upon the Lord. Learn how to call upon the Lord. Learn how to receive his spirit, his truth. Call upon the Lord.
See that?
And he will hear your prayer.
Grown ass man.
But those who love him, those who worship him, for you have the right to call upon the Lord. For you who walk in darkness, for you who walk in wickedness, for the Lord does not hear your prayer. For the Bible says, God hears not the prayer of sinners. So if you think you know God, you don't. According to the scripture. If you think you know the Lord, you don't. Lying to yourself. For he hears not the prayer of sinners. He hears not prayers of fornicators. He hears not prayers of those who don't seek him. But the prayer of those who seek him, those he hears. Those who practice the righteous acts. Those who God loves and God protects and God blesses. And those are Israelites. Those are the two people that God has made separate among all the nations. For they will inherit the kingdom. Not you wicked Elamites, not you wicked Moabites, not you wicked Amalekites, not you wicked Ammonites, not you wicked Hamites, not you wicked Ishmaelites. God don't love you, but God loves your so-called Mexicans. God loves the so-called South Americans. God loves the so-called blacks, the so-called Dominicans, the so-called Puerto Ricans, Ecuadorians, Chileans. God loves the Hispanics and Latinos. According to the Bible, you are the Israelites. According to the Bible, you are God's chosen people. But you got to come back to the Lord. You got to come out of the wickedness of this world. For the wickedness of this world is folly. The wickedness of this world will send you to eternal damnation, to the lake of eternal fire. And you don't want to be one who gets sent to the lake of eternal fire. You want to be the one who walks through those pearly gates and get accepted by the Most High God. And so we're telling you to come back to the Lord. While you got a chance, read that top straight through, King, okay? One more time.
Isaiah chapter 55, verse 6. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him when he is near.
Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Come in here to minute of the Lord right now, and you will find the Lord. For that is according to the scripture. Come and learn the history of the Bible. Stop walking in darkness. Stop walking not knowing your God. Stop walking around not knowing your true nationality. Stop walking around not knowing your original language, your true culture. But come and learn from the men of the Lord how to be born again. How to come out of all of your hard times and your hard luck. How to get your blessings, the true blessings that you deserve. You black man, you black woman. How to overcome shortcomings of being the last high, the first fire. How to overcome the ghetto, not being able to pay your bills. Come and hear the word of the Lord, the way it's supposed to be taught. Not like Reverend Hamhocken and Pastor Ribs taught you. But how the Most High God gave the Spirit to teach this truth.
Damn demon.
In sincerity. Come and hear the word of the Lord. Come on, sister, hear the word of the Lord. For the word of the Lord is not grievous. What you got?
This is the book of St. Luke, chapter 5, verse 31. And Jesus answered and said unto them, they that are whole need no physician.
What say that again, King?
This is the book of Luke, chapter 5, verse 31. And Jesus answered and said unto them, they that are whole need not a physician.
For the Bible says that they that are whole need not a physician. What does that mean? That means those that are walking in righteousness, those that understand the true gospel of the Lord, for there is salvation for them. But on the other hand, those that are not following the word of the Lord, that are walking to and fro in wickedness, for you are sick. For you are without the protection of the Lord. For you are without the protection of the angels. So you need a physician. You need someone to heal you. You need someone to protect you. You need someone to give you medicine. And as the true men of the Lord, the modern day prophets, the modern day preachers, the true preachers of the Lord, we are here to give you the medicine of the word. We are, in a sense, your physicians. But many of you scoff. Many of you turn your shoulder. Many of you are in a hurry to do wickedness. Many of you are lesbians. Many of you are transvestites. Many of you are dykes.
Right.
And you're going to hell.
Right.
According to the Bible.
That's right.
You are going to hell with gasoline underwear.
Right. Let me ride in peace.
You are going in hell.
Let me ride in peace.
No, but according to, but listen here. No, but listen. The Bible tells us we have to tell our people. We have to rebuke our people. We have to warn our people.
Right.
Don't take it so personal if it ain't cutting you like a knife. And that's a wicked damn lesbian. Dyke, butch, looking like a man. And she's going to hell if she don't repent.
Right.
And then she had the nerve to walk up on her brother.
Right.
Don't you know she'll get a two-piece? Don't you know she'll get a two-piece? And that's the problem with the women today. These so-called dyke lesbians and these trannies. They think they can walk up on a grown-ass man and talk crap. And then wonder why they walk out of there with a broken jaw. They walk out of there smacked down. Because they really have lost their way.
Salaki.
They have lost the truth.
She said, let me ride in peace.
And she wants to.
She wants to ride to hell. She wants to ride in hell.
In her gasoline underwears.
Right.
In peace.
Right.
There ain't going to be no peace.
Right.
There's no peace for the wicked. No. The Bible tells us, though, that this word is a two-edged sword. It cuts the marrow. It cuts the spirit. And so they can walk around here thinking that it's okay to be lesbians and homosexuals.
Right.
We know that they're living in wickedness.
Right.
And we know that the Spirit of the Most High God is working on them.
Right.
And they know that they're walking in darkness. And so when they hear the men of the Lord, they get cut. They get a cut like a two-edged sword. And they can't handle the truth. But whether they like it, understand it, accept it, believe it or not, the Most High's word is going out. The Most High's word is going to hit the four corners of the earth. And so if you're living in wickedness, then you're going to hear this word, whether you like it, accept it, understand it, believe it or not. Because that's what we're out here to do. We're out here to wake up our peoples. You got the, where you at? Did you finish that? Okay,
this is the book of St. Luke, chapter 5. Verse 31. And Jesus answered and said unto them, they that are whole need not a physician.
They that are whole need not a physician. But those that need medicine, they need a physician. According to the Bible, what is the medicine? The medicine is the scriptures. And you need a doctor to administer that medicine. Not a false prophet. Not a pork chop eating brethren.
Yeah,
not a ham-eating imam, but right, a true man of the Lord is going to administer this medication so that you can be healed in this truth. You know.
But they that are sick,
God, they that are sick, they need this medicine. So come and get your medicine. Come and get the word of the Lord. Come and get salvation. Learn how to put some clothes on, sisters. Learn how to have some shame. Learn that your husband is the only man that should see your private parts and your curvature. Not no stranger, according to the Bible. For the Bible tells the woman to dress in modesty. But many of you dress it like whores. Yeah, but you see that? Yeah. So. They left, so we can't get into it no more. So we tell you to dress in modesty. We tell a woman, you're not supposed to wear that which pertaineth unto a man. We tell a man, you're not supposed to wear that which pertaineth to a woman. Come out of your wickedness while there's a chance. And that's what we're here to do. Bring you out of the darkness. To teach this word, to preach this word right here on this wicked Broadway.
Book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 11.
Read it out!
And go, give thee to them of the captivity, unto the children of thy people, and speak unto them.
But the Bible tells us, we coming to give to the people of captivity. You so-called blacks, Hispanic, and Native Americans, you are still in captivity. When you worship the wicked holidays of your slave master. Captivity when you marry the oppressor. You are in captivity when you eat abominable foods. For you are still in captivity. And as the men of the Lord, we're here to tell you to come out of this captivity mentally, spiritually, emotionally, to come out of this captivity by coming back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. You so-called blacks, Hispanic, and Native American, Indians, you are God's chosen people. Not the East Indians. You're the devil that the Bible speaks of. Not the white man. You're the devil the Bible speaks of. And your wicked white woman. You're the devil the Bible speaks of. And all you heathen nations. We're here to awaken the so-called black man, the so-called Negro, out of his sleep. We're here to awaken you. To tell you to come out of your oppressors and get some true medication of the Lord. We need to get to it.
Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 11. And go, give thee to them of the captivity, unto the children of thy people.
Unto whom?
Unto the children of thy people.
Unto the children of thy people, go ahead.
And speak unto them. And tell them, thus saith the Lord God.
For we are here to speak to God's chosen people. We're here to tell you, thus saith the Lord God. According to the Bible, come out of your darkness, come out of your wickedness, and get right with the Lord by obeying his commandments, his laws, his statutes, and his ordinances to adhere to what the scriptures are telling us before it's too late. Because I love you. I love my people. And I want that you all would be saved. And this is your opportunity to get right, to start walking the path of the Lord. This is your opportunity to take a step towards the Lord while you have a chance. Because when the Savior returns, that's it. You don't have no more chance. You don't have no way of asking for forgiveness. But now is your time to awaken out of sleep. Now is the time. So that's what we're here to tell you. Give me 1 Corinthians 21. Now is the time to awaken out of sleep. And we're not going to be here forever. For the Most High has said to us that there's going to be a famine of the word. There's going to be a famine. And considering the times we're in, the Most High God for our protection is going to take us off these streets. And you won't hear the gospel. You won't hear the good news of the Lord. You so-called blacks, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Now is the time for you to hear the word. Not to walk by and miss the word of the Lord. Now is the time. Read that, King.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 1, verse 21.
Bring it out.
For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God.
For the world, in its own wisdom, doesn't know God.
Right.
And so we're here to tell you so-called blacks, Latinos, Hispanics, Native Indians, to come out of this world.
Right.
Come back into the truth of the Lord. Stop being lesbians. That's a sin. That's an abomination of the Lord. You're going to burn in hell for that. come out of this world, get right with the Lord, so that you can enter into the kingdom of God. For in my Father's house, there are many mansions. And Hamashiach Yahushua, he has gone there for 2,000 years or more to prepare for us. So you so-called blacks, Latinos, Hispanics, Native Americans, the Negro, the Indian descent, it's time for you to get right with the Lord. Now. Not now. Right now. Stop your fornication. Stop your worship of false gods. Stop your worship of your oppressor. Stop eating abominable foods. Stop loving crab and lobster and red lobster and shrimp. All that is abomination. Stop eating your pork, your ham. That's all sin according to the Most High God. And so, as a Hebrew Israelite, we're here to wake up and tell our brothers and our sisters to get right with the Lord now. To stop smoking weed. Stop smoking cigarettes. Don't you know that your body is the temple of God and the Spirit of God dwells in you? For stay away from those things that defile the body. And get with those things that are upright, that uplift the spirit and the soul. For you are a beautiful nation. You don't need blue hair. You're a beautiful nation. What happened to your natural? You don't love yourself, you got a color of blue, blonde, green. You want to be like your oppressor? Well, you're going to go to hell for that.
Right.
And so with that, there's a lot more I can say. So, you read our first Corinthians? Okay. Huh? Okay, so finish that up. Start from the top.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 1, verse 21. For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God.
The world by wisdom doesn't know God, but it's time for the Israelite nation to know God. Go ahead.
It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe.
For it pleases the Most High God that by the foolishness of coming out here in the highways and the byways to preach this gospel to the Israelites. It pleases the Most High that we take on the shame of what you call shame to come out here and preach this gospel. But this is no shame for us. We love the Lord. We love His word. So you may think that we're foolish preaching this gospel. But we know that this is our duty. This is our calling of the Most High God. And we do it because our spirit is willing. And freely we receive, so freely we give. So with that, I say, Kohala Yahara, Bashema Mashiach Yahara Shai, the Rakata Yahara, the Rakata Yahara Shai, the Rada Yahara, the Rada Yahara Shai, for all your blessings, Abinaba Yahara. Shalom.
Shalom. I'm going to give Toby 15 minutes, and then I'll give you 30. Yeah, it's right there. It's in the green. You got extra batteries?
I got extra batteries just in case.
All right.
So yours is good, right?
Yeah. So you got 15 minutes.
Okay, right. No problem.
1, 2.
Shalom.
Go to 19. Go to Genesis 19:31, and then read the 32.
Shalom. All praises to the Most High. Pa, Allah, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahusha, in the name of His Son Yahusha. Now, last week, you know, I got rudely disturbed by this mole bite. You know what I mean? So, forgive me, fellas, but I'm going to go in on her. Read that, because y'all incense babies.
Book of Genesis, chapter 19 and verse 31.
Read it out.
And the firstborn said unto the younger, our father is old, and there is not a man in the earth to come in unto us after the manner of all the earth.
So now, these Moabites out here showing their butt off, you know, but y'all don't know that your lot had incest babies, y'all some incest babies. You understand what I'm saying? And Lot had children with his daughter had children with his father, and y'all became the Moabites. You understand? So let me tell y'all something.
Verse 32.
Let us make our father drink wine, and we will lie with him, that we may preserve seed.
So now Lot's daughter, you know, was on some conniving stuff. They said, you know, let's go have babies. Let's go get our father drunk, you know, and lay down with him. And this would happen.
Verse 36. Thus were both the daughters of Lot with child by their father, and the firstborn bare a son and called his name Moab.
Moab, you hear that? You know that? Lot's daughter had a son by her father, and it was a Moabites. That's your Chinese group.
And the same until today are the Moabites. And the younger, she also bare a son and called his name Ben-Ami. The same is the father of the children of Ammon until this day.
And that's your Chinese little goat, okay? Give me some. 67. So I'm kind of upset, but this dude gonna interrupt me last week. You know what I mean? Don't know she gonna be a wash pot. You know what I mean? When sooner or later she gonna be a wash pot. Her time is coming. Real soon, your time is coming. Real soon.
This is the book of Psalms. I don't know why it's not coming out. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 60, verse 7. Gilead. You mean verse 8? This is the book of Psalms. Chapter 60, verse 8. Moab is my wash pot.
What? What he say?
Moab is my wash pot.
Yeah, wait. Y'all gonna be a stink wash pot. Real soon when the Most High come back. Give me Deuteronomy 23. Y'all gonna be a wash pot real soon. Real soon, you're very disrespectful. It got the nerve to have that Bible in your head. Second Samuel 8:2.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23, verse 2. A bastard shall not enter into the congregation of the Most High. Even to his 10th generation shall he not enter into the congregation of the Most High. An Ammonite or a Moabite shall not enter into the congregation of the Lord, even to their 10th generation. Shall they not enter into the congregation of the Lord forever?
Look at this. So why you got that Bible in your hand? You can't enter the congregation at all. I don't even know why you got that Bible in your hand, and you got these people out here, you know what I mean, beside y'all, teaching that bone junk, you know what I mean? And they don't know that you know what I mean, they gonna die too. Getting led wrong by your little Moab and stuff, your little garbage, your little wash pots.
It's the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 8, verse 2.
Bring it out.
And he smote Moab and measured them with a line.
So this is our forefather David. When he was getting his kingdom established, you know what I mean? He would smoke all of y'all. Cause that's what y'all gonna get. Y'all gonna get smoked. All of y'all gonna get smoked. Y'all can sit up in there and read the Bible all y'all want, but y'all gonna get smoked. Y'all gonna get smoked. You hear me?
Give me Proverbs 11:21.
Y'all get smoked. And all them Sambo black, that black girl and the Sambo black man over here that's always over here every week. Preaching to you with those crosses in your hand, you watch, you see, you sample asses.
It's the book of Proverbs, chapter 11, verse 21.
Bring it out.
No hand joining man. The wicked shall not be unpunished.
So y'all can go hand in hand with these Moabites and all the rest of these nations, you know what I mean? But I let you know right now, the Most High don't like that, and y'all can keep holding hands, throw hand in your hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished, so that any one of y'all so-called black Hispanics and Native American Indians over there with that Moabite, y'all gonna be watch box too. You understand that? You got them preaching that nasty stuff over there. Cut it out. You know what I mean? Your so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, y'all need to come back to this truth. That's the only way y'all gonna survive. Give me Deuteronomy 7-6. That's the only way you'll give me That's the only way y'all gonna survive. I need Deuteronomy 14-2. That's the only way y'all gonna survive. You're over there, y'all act like y'all shaming your God. You get what I mean? And y'all holy people. You're separate people to all the people in this world, in this nation. You understand? But y'all want to keep going, walking by. It's about to be the Sabbath day. It's about to be Sabbath. And I see everybody still got to go shopping. You're defiling the Sabbath day in a little while. Bring that out, man.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6.
Bring it out.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So,
Elon,
the Lord said, y'all above all people. So y'all above all people upon the face of this earth, but y'all gonna scoop so low to be around these crackers, these white folks, y'all wanna scoop so low, y'all are oppressive people, peculiar people to the Most High. But no, just because they ruling this world and everything, and they feel as though they better than you, you just want to say, oh, I want to be like them. When you're better than these people already. You're better than these people already, but yet y'all want to be equal to these people that for thousands and hundreds of years done destroyed you. You get what I mean? Done fed you lies. Done almost wiped out the Native American Indians, our brothers. You get what I'm saying? So y'all ashamed to be an Israelite, a Hebrew Israelite. Okay, it's a penalty for that one.
This is the book of Luke, chapter 9, verse 26. For whosoever shall be ashamed of me and of my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed, when he shall come in his own glory and in his Father's and of the holy angels.
So, y'all can walk around here ignoring the fact that y'all Hebrew Israelites, or y'all don't know your heritage and don't want to know your heritage. Y'all can keep walking around here blindfolded and in the dark and being ashamed of your heritage and who y'all are and who your God is. Y'all gonna get destroyed because y'all ashamed. Y'all ashamed. You know what I mean? Israel will never wax pale. You know what I mean? Just get over it. You know what I mean? The Most High don't like your white people. Just get over it. He don't like your East Indian, your Moabites, your Chinese, your Africans. Just get over it. And your so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, y'all gotta get with the program or get fried like bacon. You understand what I'm saying? You come back to your Lord's statutes and commandments. That's the only way y'all gonna get around this. There's no fighting this. You get what I mean? You fight. Only thing you're doing, y'all ain't fighting us when we come out here preaching the news. Y'all ain't fighting us. You're bucking up against the Lord. Y'all ain't bucking up against us. You're bucking up against the Lord. Because obviously y'all don't know y'all was sold to your enemies and y'all gonna serve your enemies. But yet y'all love them. Y'all love this captivity. Y'all love this captivity. I want to stay in captivity for the rest of your life. But it ain't gonna be like that. It's not gonna be like that. You understand what I'm saying?
Give me 2 Thessalonians 1:6.
It ain't gonna be like that. It ain't gonna be like that. So you just gotta understand, you know, that it's a punishment. Just like they devoured us, we gonna devour them. You understand what I'm saying? So you can't hold their hand, you know what I mean? And you get caught with these people, y'all don't get thrust through. If you understand what that means. So leave these people alone, separate from these people, your so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. Y'all need to separate from these other nations, because these other nations do not like y'all.
That's right. This is the book of 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6. See, it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to
what
them that trouble you, and to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Habashek Yahawashai shall be revealed from heaven and his mighty angels.
So, it's a fact that all these other nations has troubled us. It's a fact. The white man put us in slavery, killed our babies, broke our men, you get what I'm saying, took our babies away, broke up our families. You understand what I'm saying? They troubled us. These Chinese groups, you know what I mean? They don't like us. They got a problem with us. These East Indians got a problem with us. When did